Okay, I want to take a moment and I want you to look at this plant. If you look here, we have a whole field of something called sheep sorrel. And it's been out here for a while. And upon further inspection, I noticed something very interesting that identified this particular species. If you look here, let's zoom in on one that's maturing because it's still kind of early. Let's see if I can find one. All right, if you look closely down here at the actual leaf, I'm gonna pick one here. You're gonna notice that there's a little, it looks like, you have three leaves there. Well, let's get a bigger one so you can see it. Okay, this one right here in my hand. Okay, if you look here, there's an interesting characteristic. Let me see if I can zoom in on this thing. All right, there we go. Okay. All right, there you go. Now you see the leaf, and then you see the two little fins on the left and right side. This is unique to this particular plant, and that's one of the ways to identify the sheep sorrel. And so we have it growing out in abundance, as you can see. The whole field is covered with it. And we're going to go ahead and start drying this out so we can use it. What made this formula so effective for cancer was that when it was used by the nurse years ago in this country, what she would do is she would get it directly out the garden and utilize it. So it wasn't stored up and dried out and, you know, and all of those things. She used it upon picking it. And so we're going to do something similar here. We have the herb here that actually treats the cancer. Then we have the one for the AIDS virus. It's called pokeru, and that grows in abundance out here. And as you can see, the field that we normally look at and kind of say, oh man, look at all these weeds. We need to go ahead and tear this up and put down some beautiful St. Augustine grass. Well, that partly is due to ignorance, because what you have here normally in your yard are various species of herbs, such as dandelion, which is a powerful blood purifier. And of course, you know, we have sheep sorrel out here. And the more you look around, the more you'll find something. I even found a white oak tree, which you can use the inner bark for treating periodontal disease in the gums. You just cut the inner bark and then you place it within the gums, in between the gum and the teeth, or the lip and the teeth, and let it come in contact with the gums, and you sleep with it overnight for 6 nights. And there's been testimonies after testimony of people fixing the condition of gum disease. So I just wanted to go ahead and make this short recording so that we can get it out of our head that these things are weeds. They're actually herbs of the field. That's what the Bible refers to them as. And they're medicinal. The animals ate the green herb from the beginning. And then, of course, when sin entered into the world, God permitted man to eat these same plants. So the herb itself is actually food. It's medicated food. It's a natural medicine. And we've gotten far from that. But we shouldn't put anything in our body that God did not give permission for us to eat. So all the things that are recorded in Genesis chapter 1 as it pertains to the herb-bearing seed and the fruit tree yielding seed, and then the green herb of the field, which is later introduced to man, all of these things are edible, and God have designed our bodies to where we can not only accept, but we can assimilate the constituents found within these particular crops. So keep that in mind. Hopefully, as our knowledge base increases on the different types of medicinal plants that we have on the property, what we'll do is we'll make videos such as this and go into more detail on them. But this is a blessing, and keep pressing forward. Don't be discouraged, and don't spray weed killer on your lawn and kill all the medicine, and then turn around and take the chemicals that kill the herbs as medication. It just, it's kind of lack of common sense. So I just wanted to show you that. There goes another view of it. Very beautiful. And you can only imagine how much sheep sorrel tea you can get out of that. press for it.